My name is Nate. I am the co-founder of Apipheny.io, and then I am also a growth marketer and also a freelance data analyst. And today I'm going to actually be showing you how to import a JSON API into Google Sheets. Now, you're probably asking, what is an API? So an API is an application programming interface, and it's pretty much the interface that allows different software platforms to communicate with one another. Now, you're probably asking, how do they communicate with one another? Well, that's where the JSON API comes in. And JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation. And this is the language that, the coding language that is used for those software interfaces to communicate with one another. In this case, we're going to be using Google Sheets, and we're also going to be using Google Apps Script to communicate with those different software platforms or the different APIs that we're going to import into this Google Sheet. So there's two ways to do this. There is using Google Apps Script, which is a coding language that allows you to write code for G Suite products, whether it's Gmail, whether it's Google Calendar, or maybe you are using Google Sheets like you are here. The second way is to use a Google Sheets add-on that you can get from the G Suite marketplace called Apipheny. And that Google Sheets add-on will allow you to import any JSON API without writing any code. So with that being said, let's go ahead. And so the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to open up a Google Sheet just like I have here. And then what you're going to actually do to import a JSON using Google Apps Script is you're going to go to Tools, you're going to go to Script Editor, and that will allow you to create a code. Now, I have the code written here already because, you know, I wanted to prepare for this video. But what I actually did is I actually went on to GitHub. And GitHub is a repository for code like this, where individuals are able to upload it, they're able to collaborate on it, and they also allow people to use, you know, the code that they created for uses like this. So this was an actual import JSON app script that this guy named Paul wrote, and I was able to copy that into the script editor and make sure that everything was, you know, perfect as far as this code goes. And then I was able to go to File, I was able to save it and also run it. So let's go ahead and go back to our Google Sheet and run this code. So what we're going to do to run this code is we're actually going to have a little fun here. We're going to use the Pokemon API that I have here, and I'm going to use the Pokemon API to import information. So what we're going to do here is we're going to use a function, and that function is import JSON. Just like how in Excel you can use the sum formula or the average formula, you're going to use that here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that Pokemon API, we're going to copy it over, and we're going to pull in the Pokemon Dittos information. So let's type in equals. And it's going to be a function just like how you use Excel, you know, where you're using the sum function or average function. We're going to use JSON. And then we're going to have parentheses, quotations. Very important to import your URL. I'm going to copy that URL, and then type in Pokemon/ditto. And then close that, and close that. And boom. It pulled all the information regarding Ditto, like what Pokemon game it was on, their attributes, their different abilities, you know, what color they are, all that good stuff. So you can see it here in sheet one. And that's the first example that I wanted to give you guys. Let's do another one just for good measure. So let's open up a new sheet here. We don't need to worry about going into the script editor now because we already have that script added to this Google Sheet. So we don't have to worry about, you know, importing it here. So let's go back to here and let's use equals import JSON. Now I have another API that I want to use. We're going to have a lot of fun this video, guys. So we're going to use the Chuck Norris API and we're going to import that information. So let's go over to the Chuck Norris API and let's import the random jokes that they have about Chuck Norris. Let's copy this URL Let's put this into the formula, close the parentheses, let it run. All right. So we have here when Barack Obama said, yes, we can, he was actually referring to Chuck Norris. So we have our political random Chuck Norris joke right here, and it pulled it in perfectly. So that's how you import a JSON API using Google Apps Script. What I did is I went to GitHub. I found the source code that I was able to use. I'll actually put that in the description, so you're more than welcome to use it as well. And you were able to pull in the JSON API from both the Pokemon API and the Chuck Norris API using Google Apps Script. So so that's it. That's the first method. Now let's talk about the second method. That second method is using the Google Sheets add-on Apipheny to import the JSON import a JSON API. Now the difference between that Apipheny and then using this method is that not only will you be able to have these requests, but you'll also be able to save it, and then you'll also be able to schedule those requests as well. So let's go ahead and give it a try. We're gonna go to add-ons, and Apipheny usually isn't here, but then you would type in get add-ons and you would type in Apipheny. I'll have the link in the description as well, so you don't even have to worry about typing it in. It'll take you directly to the add-on that we created for you guys, and then you'll be able to install it, no problems. So once that's installed, go to add-ons and you'll go to Apipheny. And you'll go to import API, and then it'll open up the API importer interface. So just to break it down for you guys here, you have two methods that you can use the API importer for. There's get, and then there's post. Get allows you to receive information from an API using JSON, and then post allows you to send information using that JSON language. So in this case, we're gonna use get for our sample. But let's keep on scrolling down. So headers, this is where if maybe you're maybe the software that you want to import into Google Sheets has the API key, this is where you would enter API key. And this is where you would enter your value of that API key, which would be 1, 2, 3, 4 in this example. Append is that maybe you have information. I'll slide over here to the middle. Maybe you have rows 1 through 10 filled out and you want to add API data to row 11. So that allows you to use append mode and it won't overwrite any of the information that you had in rows 1 through 10. You can also timestamp your data pools. Like I said, you are going to be able to schedule requests using this API importer. So if you want to include the date of when that data was pulled, you're more than welcome to do that as well. So. And then run or save. You can either save the request or you can run it because it's more of a one-off request. So let's go ahead and give our importer a try. Let's go ahead and let's just start off with a simple one. Let's do cat facts. So I'm gonna go here, I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna go back to my Google Sheet and I'm gonna enter in cat facts. Don't need to worry about any headers, don't need to append it to anything. We're just gonna go ahead and run it. And here are your cat facts. Let's take a look at row 5. Evidence suggests domesticated cats have been around since 3600 BC, 2000 years before Egypt's pharaohs. Wow, all right, we got some good stuff here. Only a cat can reduce their hooves to stroke and heart attack by a third. Wouldn't doubt it. I'm a dog guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. So that's how you can import information using Apipheny without a API key. Now let's try one with the API key. Now I end up pulling the API from Empire Flippers, and Empire Flippers is actually a website that will allow you to buy or sell any website that you want to or may own. It can be maybe you have an e-commerce website, maybe you have a blog, maybe you have an Amazon FBA seller account. So there's a lot of different things that you can do on Empire Flippers. Maybe you have a SaaS product like Apipheny, but you are able to import that information using JSON. So let's go ahead and copy their API. Let's go back to our Google Sheet and let's get rid of, let's do a new sheet. Let's get rid of CatFax, put in Empire Flippers. Now there are gonna be values that we can enter here. So we're gonna add a new row and let's get all the listings from page 3. So for key, we're gonna put page, and then for value, we're gonna put 3. And then we don't need to append it to everything because we have a new sheet. Don't need to worry about the date. So let's click run. And boom, we were able to import all the listings from page 3 from Empire Flippers. As you see, we got some e-commerce sites, we got some FBA accounts, we got a good amount of stuff here. So that's the way that you're able to pull in an API URL using headers, if you have an API key or something similar like that. That's the two ways to import a JSON API in the Google Sheets. Just a review. The first option is using Google Apps Script, you know, writing your own code or using somebody else's code to import that. The only thing with that is there are some limitations, like you may not be able to schedule a request, you won't be able to save requests, and then also you have to learn how to write JSON and import and, you know, use that code in order to import the data. And the second way is using a Google Sheets add-on like Apipheny, where you don't have to have any code, you just need to know the URL, maybe the different parameters that you want to pull in, and then your API key or access token. And as far as reporting goes, I mean, you can use Google Sheets if you would like. Google Sheets does have a lot of different ways where you can, you know, create pivot tables, you can, you know, create different graphs and things like that. So you can do a lot of different things within Google Sheets. But I actually prefer to use something else when I'm importing data into Google Sheets and want to report on it. I like to use Google Data Studio. And Google Data Studio is a product created by Google, and it actually connects directly to Google Sheets, so it's perfect for that. And you're able to create a report like this. In this example, you're seeing GA data, but you can use, you know, data from Search Console. You can use data from any API that you would like to pull in. Maybe you want to, you know, create a report on the different cat facts or something like that. You're able to create things like scorecards, you're able to create graphs, you're able to create a breakdown by country. Let me slide myself over. And you're able to see a lot, you are able to create tables, you know, you can create different bar graphs like this. So it's a pretty interesting tool. The only thing is, there is a steep learning curve to learning how to create these reports. And this report and creating reports like this is one of my specialties. So I'm more than happy to help you guys out with that. I'll actually put my link in the description below. If you guys would like me to help you with reporting, more than happy to do that. I respond fairly quickly to any inquiries that I may have. So if you guys want any information on that, just let me know. But that's it as far as importing JSON API into Google Sheets. And also reporting as well. So if you guys have any questions, just leave a comment below, or, you know, you can go to my website, send me a message, go to epiphany.com, send us your questions as far as using our add-on. We're more than happy to help you guys. With that being said, onwards and upwards, guys. See you guys in the next video.